मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द पैडागोजिकल बायोलॉजिकल टॉपिक ऑडियो विजुअल एड. इन ऑडियो विजुअल एड आई हैव डिस्कस ऑलरेडी. इन दैट वी हैव लर्न अबाउट चार्ट एज अ टीचिंग एड. सो चार्ट इज ए गुड मीन्स ऑफ एड ऑफ टीचिंग. इट ब्रिंग्स एनवायरमेंट through the process of teaching inside the class indirectly. Instead of visiting the actual field of a lesson in real life, the chart can bring such scene into class to be seen by learners. The purpose is to give life to the theoretical learning. It facilitates the process of presentation in class. A chart is a useful way to present the display information or instructions, especially in class or other educational situation. It can range in size from a large ball chart to a single piece of paper. So these were some uses. Now definition, if we talk about definition, then chart is a group of related facts presented in the form of a diagram, table, graph or other visually organized model. Example like alphabet chart or other scientific diagram we can draw in the chart, and we can explain from the picture to the students. Now kinds, here are some kinds of chart. Like first alphabet chart, consonant chart, enlarged primer page, number chart, punctuation chart, song chart, vowel chart. These are some kinds of chart. Benefits, what are the benefits of chart? There are some benefits. Charts are an excellent tool that can help students become independent thinkers and problem solvers when working to master the CSS. And although the standards are complex, when the process are broken down displayed for students, they can more easily internalize and master them. Charts don't have to be perfect. They are more successful when they are created by or with students and modified or altered as students' understanding of the concepts changes. How can a teacher create these kind of charts? For this, there are some points to describe. That a chart should reflect the student's reading level. Smarter charts recommended that the chart created in the classroom mimic the amount of print on a page, the spacing between word and the number of lines of print that children are used to seeing in their reading. Therefore, first grade charts would look much different from fourth or fifth grade charts. Charts should be created with students so that they have some ownership of what goes it and will therefore refer to it. It is not necessary that the entire chart is created together, but it should not be something that it is completely pre-made either. Chart should be a work in progress, one that helps students to remember the major points of the mini lesson on you teach. There has to be some system in place that helps students to remember to refer to chart when needed. After all, that is why they are created, to help students become independent problem solvers. Systems could include simple things such as having students post it, not that chart they used want to use. Student can get science chart, they have become expert, or and then other students can go to them for help. Teachers could ask students which chart could help you with that. During mini lesson, after workshop, shares or conference, the idea is to constantly remind students to use the chart and information that is available to them. They are not wallpaper. Now here are some characteristic chart. The chart should be clear, easy to understand and easy to find. The display content on the chart will be in current and support complex skills. The chart have a clear purpose. The chart includes steps for how to do specific strategies or procedures. This also have is visual, including symbols, pictures or photos to go with others. Thank you.